people in the room, but I don't know what Berkshire Regional Planning Commission is. Let me give you the two-minute drill. We're a governmental entity, a sub-state district in the official parlance. We're not a nonprofit, although we do have a nonprofit affiliate, Berkshire Smart. We're established under state law. Each town and city in the county, all 32, are represented equally. We're empowered to study and plan for the region. Planning and studying without action is an interesting academic exercise, but it doesn't get you very far. We're increasingly an implementation agency outside the bounds of our legislation. Our website is www.berkshiresplanning.org. Scan through it and you can see, get a better idea of the breadth of our work and our involvement across the region. And I started thinking a little bit when I got coached on kind of what we're trying to do today and just why am I doing the kind of work I've been doing for 36 years now. How many of you all can remember specific images from Life magazine? I think most of us are probably about that age. And a set of images that have stuck with me throughout my life are the poverty images in Appalachia as well as the rest of America, as the war on poverty was something we were trying to accomplish as a nation. And that's ultimately what got me into planning and still forms a key part of the work I do, how I approach it. Second part is I grew up in an entrepreneurial family and believe regional planning commissions to survive have to be very entrepreneurial. And finally, I enjoy analyzing complex public policy issues and developing initiatives to try to address what you confront in those. And what I want to talk about today is our Sustainable Berkshires Plan, which Elizabeth brought up. We had the food and agriculture element is one of the eight elements in that plan. It is, end of the day, the plan could have used a severe editing, but it has a lot of great information and ideas in it. It's a very multifaceted, very complex, long-range plan for the region. Ultimately, much of what I got out of it was one key issue that I'm going to talk about in a couple of minutes. But it covers conservation and recreation, the land around us, the landscape we see, economy, local food and agriculture, climate change and energy, housing and neighborhoods, historic preservation, infrastructure and services, and land use, which our old regional plan more or less focused primarily on land use. And all of these are interrelated in any community, and ours in some very unusual ways. Now, sustainability is the current buzz term for a healthy community, a healthy region, and the primary three factors as we view them are social factors, economic factors, and environmental factors. Frankly, the Berkshires come closest to being sustainable environmentally in many ways. Economically and socially, we are not a sustainable county right now. And Elizabeth alluded to this as well over younger people and the need to give younger people opportunities here. Let's see if I get this right. Okay. Told you I was technically illiterate. This. On economic sustainability, this is our trend line for the past 40 years of income levels in this region, adjusted for inflation. Median household income has fallen about 14% over those 40 years. We went from being above the national average to being below the national average. And I also would like to say we're really two regions. I don't have me do it, right? Okay, you do it. Okay. And I want to show of hands. How many of you live in Berkshire, your primary, your home in Berkshire County is Pittsfield and North? From Pittsfield and North. To Pittsfield to the North. Okay. A few people. I presume everyone else is south of Pittsfield. Is that correct? Okay. And I think that is important to realize. We are really two regions. And just two snippets of information here. Let's see if that... Okay, well, I'm trying to do the pointer. Okay. Back to the previous one. Just while that's coming up, Pittsfield, North Adams, and Adams contain 50% of the region's population. Collectively, about 70% of the children, young children who are low income, live in those three communities. 70%. So half the population, 70% of the kids. Same three communities, about 73% of the single family, single mother families are low income. So you have a concentration of poverty, and we are talking about numbers you wouldn't want to have to live on. So that's why I, particularly in Southern Berkshire, and not that there aren't low income people here too, but the northern half of the region really is an economically depressed region, very significantly so. Move on to the next one, which is population sustainability. This is our population graph from the first U.S. Census in 1790 through 2010, which is not all the way down this side, with an expectation of, given our age demographics, by 2060, the county's population will be about 80,000 people, which was what it was in 1890. That is without some substantial underlying change in dynamics, and this is just based on pure trend analysis. So, you know, it's to be taken with a grain of salt, but we're not unique in this, believe me. Almost all of the non-major metro Northeast and Rust Belt look this way. But it is an incredible dynamic. This was the graph that smacked me on the side of the head when I saw it developed. And this is all attributable to us baby boomers and our impact on the population. And what has happened subsequent to that. Next one. This gives you what we have is a population change from 1970, or the blue lines, by five-year ages. Five-year age cohorts, the red are 2010. You can see what a drop-off in younger ages. Everything prior to 40-year-olds we have had, and a increase 40-plus, but nowhere near to the extent we've had the drop-off in percentage of younger people. This is attributable to the manufacturing loss in the 70s, 80s, into the early 90s. Young working families left this region in droves and have not returned. And go on to the next one, because this is actually a national and Massachusetts trend as well. Berkshire's in the red, Massachusetts is the blue, the national is the green. You know, you see some of the same dynamics, but nowhere near to the same extent that we're experiencing them. You know, we have a marked loss of folks after college age, and the only reason we've got the spike in the 20-year-olds is because of Williams, MCLA, ECC, and Simon's Rock bringing kids in or keeping them here for a while, but then they leave. You know, we don't have the balance of the millennial generation that nationwide there is. Millennials are actually larger than the baby boomers now. But we don't get them, so we've got a loss of lack of those folks. And of course, they're at the age right now, they're the ones having kids. You know, 20 to 35-year-olds, 40-year-olds, they have kids. You get to 60, you don't have kids. You hope you don't, anyway. Okay, so, why don't we take, I don't have any more graphics, and that's so depressing, I want to get it off of there. Okay, what can we do about it? You know, we can moan and groan, and a lot of, there are other places asking this. We do have a population task force that has sprung up in, to deal with this. It's being led by the One Berkshires, our regional economic development organization. It's just recently started to get itself together. Its initial focus is going to be on retaining and attracting back 22 to 40-year-olds. What can we do? About half of the task force is that age group. So, you know, it's not just folks like me who think we know what they might should do and want. There's a lot of well-documented research on what kinds of places attract that generation, those folks, and what they want. They want to be in places with a buzz, some activity, things going on, a lot of social activity, informal ways to get social, be socialized. They want connectivity, both electronic and physical, with options. Want to be in fairly dense mixed-use areas. They don't want to be in the burbs. They don't want to be raised the way their parents were. Want to be engaged in their communities, and they want to be engaged in meaningful work. And they want recreation and activity options that are convenient. Now you run through that laundry list, and frankly, we ought to be doing better than we're doing. So maybe we're doing a lousy job of marketing ourselves. But I think there are some challenges that we have to confront too. The buzz factor. I would say we have some on a relatively small scale in several of our downtown areas and the surrounding neighborhoods. Barrington probably has the best concentration. Pittsfield drops off some, but is a little too scattered, and there are challenged neighborhoods around it, and it's hit or miss. North Adams, it's not prevalent enough. Lee has it, but it's on a really small scale. I think outside of those, I'm not sure that we really do in the region, but we've got some opportunities to make those more than they are. We're experimenting, one of the young task force members is experimenting with, maybe there's a way to create the buzz with a lot of virtual means. When you start to look at how much is going on in the region, the access to activities, events, places to get together, if you do it so that message is out electronically, as long as you're willing to drive a little bit, it's there. Connectivity, broadband, you know, we finally have Estwood and Middle Mile network for broadband, because it exists probably in the corner. We still have the last mile issues to deal with. That's going to be coming at us, and I ask people to really pay attention to what's going on in your town governments, because they are going to be asked to step up to the plate. If y'all want it, you're going to have to support it. There will be state support for it, but it's not going to come without a need for local support too. And by that, I mean showing up at town meeting and voting for some money that ultimately is going to be necessary. But we can have it. We're that far from it, folks, but it's going to take people showing up and really pushing for it because there's always the naysayers. Wireless is still pretty spotty. Millennials will complain about that anytime you give them a chance. You know, one spot is fine, you walk across the room and it's not. My house is that way. Physical, you know, we're not going to be building a lot of highways. Anybody who has that vision, forget it. Traditional transit doesn't work in our environment very well, so we have to deal with that. We need to come up with different solutions, and I think this is going to take some real creativity. But the other part of it is get good housing close to where people want to recreate and socialize. You know, walking is a great form of transportation if it's only for a few blocks in January even. We do have in-town living. You know, one of our strengths is, particularly Pittsfield and Northward, you can buy a pretty decent house for a very affordable price. If you want to rent something, the quality stinks. And I'm just being blunt about that. And we have to deal with that, of making our downtowns as attractive as we can be, having them mixed use. Housing leads, retail follows. And that's important for people to understand. And frankly, in the northern half of the region, we've got to nudge the development and rental community to start nudging rents up. They charge so little, they don't have enough to invest in the properties. It's kind of a chicken and egg problem. So then you don't attract quality tenants that want to pay a decent rent or can afford to pay a decent rent. It's not an issue in Great Barrington, and I recognize that's, again, why we've got really, in some ways, two regions. The other two things, I mean, getting engaged, I don't know if there's a place in the world where it's easier to get engaged in things that are meaningful than in the Berkshires. You know, I think that's one of the wonderful things about it. We probably need to market that better, make information about ways to do it, or the opportunities to do it more available. And really, that's part of the media strategy that this group's been starting to develop is, let's get word out, get people to, you know, show their friends what you can do, starting to work with major employers, and then try to get down as far as we can with smaller employers to capture their new hires and get them into the community, engaged in the community in a positive way. General Dynamics will tell you, if they don't, with the new engineers they're bringing in, if they don't get them involved in the community within 6 months, they leave. If they get them involved, they stay. Their turnover rate is the lowest of any General Dynamics facility in the country. recreation and activity options. If you're 5 minutes from recreation around here, I think it's, you've got to be in some place pretty bizarre. You know, you can hike, bike, ski, canoe, kayak within 15 minutes from any place in the county, I think. You know, and you certainly have plenty of options for the informal things, going to farmers markets on the weekend or on a Wednesday. You know, doing those kinds of things that are activities, and they're attractive to this age group. So a lot of it is making the activities known and really pushing the heck out of how much of that goes on here. And I think that's really our next big push with this group, is figuring out, using all the good electronic media, how to market the Berkshires better to attract a younger population. So, thank you much.